Good evening, everybody. Am I audible? Yeah. Today's my topic is design experiences for children. Myself Chaitali. I am working as a UX consultant with ULF Pune, and also I lead a creative group in Pune called Creative Doodle. So I work with a lot of kids and lot of parents. But it's not a digital platform, but in person I interact with a lot of kids. My presentation is based on my experience as a parent, as a user experience designer, and what I observe as a behavior with the kids within my workshop, creative workshops. Starting with the topic. How kids are different. When we are designing experiences for children, it's not only simplification of UI or just putting any big buttons, putting any funky colors, so make them attract. But we, as a user experience designer, we need to think of their mindset. We need to think of interaction patterns. We need to think of user experience in perspective for a point child's point of view. Yes, children are curious and love to explore. Young kids have no go-to pattern, no mold, no expectation about how something should work. Children can have different interaction patterns and mindset. As a experienced designer, we need to think of range of possibilities, because each age group will interact with the interface differently. If we are working, designing any interface for a toddler, we need to consider that he is in a learning phase. He has not yet developed his motor skill. So we need to think of his interaction point of view. But if we are designing for an elder kid, so we need to consider he is more interested in entertainment, fun, excitement. He is more interested to have some voice which will engage him into the interface or app. Let's discuss with one child-centric design model. This one is proposed by uxkids.com. This is a very good site, and you can refer this site. The main blogger, Sabina Adler, she is doing a lot of work with user experience for kids. They are doing user testing with kids on the apps and all. So what they propose is, it's similar kind of model with the UCD model, user-centric model we work. But the difference is they have added an age-appropriate slab in the model. It is based on the cognitive growth theory. What is cognitive growth theory? If we consider a kid of 0 to 2 years age group, so the learning pattern will be like he's in the sensory motor intelligence. He's in development phase of sensory motor intelligence. If we consider of age group of 4 to 7 years old kid, so he must be knowing some intuitive features. Means cognitive growth is coming up. And if a elder kid, if we are taking, he is more, he can do more concrete operations on the interface. So the basic thing is, like, each slab has its own features. If fun part, if it is loved by all the kids, definitely our application or interface, it will get more share, it will get more like. And if it is easy to use, beside kids, it is also appreciated by teachers, because they can use that application for the education purpose. And definitely, as a parent, I am more concerned the app or the content, whatever my kid is using, is it safe for his entertainment or education? So age-appropriate slab mostly deals with the parents' concern, and definitely meet your business goal if it is loved by our stakeholder and client. It is very important for us to make them happy. What are the key considerations we need to consider? Affordance is the key. As my observation, I believe that kids interact with the technology as a toy, as he interact with the nature in the past. So whatever he interact with the application or any interface, he will expect the same response from the interface from his day-to-day activity. If a kid tap on a water, he will expect a water ripple from that water. So he will interrelate those things with his day-to-day activity. This is very good example of Disney app mates. I will share their video.
Disney and Pixar's Cars 2 comes AppMates, a never-before-seen magical new iPad experience. Place your favorite character on your iPad to unlock the world of Cars.
It's me, Lightning McQueen.
Each character comes to life with real lights, character voices, and sound effects. Just download the app from the App Store to race and explore.
Sweet!
Do huge jumps, smash and crash. From Radiator Springs to Tokyo, it's a virtual endless world of fun, off-roading, and launching missiles. With AppMates in your iPad, the adventure feels so real. Looking good, Mater.
Head gun. Thanks.
AppMates brings the world of Cars to life. You can get the McQueen and Holly cars. You'll also get a rubber slip mat and a cleaning cloth. App available at the App Store, iPad.
Coming back to the presentation, if you observe what they have done, they have designed few specific cars, and they have make a virtual playground as a tab. It's a free app you can download, but the effects they have given is like it's a radiator spring if a particular character, if it is a night, they will show a headlight, and the feeling, it's like natural thing which will attract and engage the kid. So definitely affordance is the very key consideration we have to consider. Child-proof navigation interface. Children are more prone to undershoot their targets, and also there are more prone to accidental multi-touch. So we need to design interfaces or navigation which are more useful while they are navigating through the app. Like in this example, the least used menu they have placed at the topmost corner, but the next previous button they have placed at the bottommost corner. So kid can use it very efficiently. Understand kids' gesture the right way. Nowadays kids are very smart and they can pick quick technology and quick gesture quickly. But the advanced gesture like multi-touch, swiping, all increase the learnability of your app. So though we are giving a unique gesture which will attract the kid towards your app, but we need to think that it will also increase the learnability of your app. Testing the patience. I hope most of them, you are parents, and most of them, you means you have kids. So you must be knowing that kids don't have patience. So, as per my own example, when my kid is playing with any game on the tab, and if something takes time to load, he just come up and complain, your app is not working, or something goes wrong. So that much of patience kids don't have. So whenever we are designing for a toddler, splash screens or loading screen might not get interested. The kid may not be interested in that. But if it is a requirement from the back end, then we have to consider some animation or something engaging part in the screen so that the kid will be keep engaged to the screen. I want to add accessibility for children. Actually, I was expecting more talks on accessibility and UX because this one factor is more important when we are considering some UX for any application or interface. Around 10 billion people from the developing countries, most of around 10 billion people are suffering from different disabilities, and within them 10% are children. So I believe that all children deserve fair chance to have a great user experience in terms of knowledge and fun, including children with disabilities. This one example I want to explain is like, this slide is from a company, Barrierbrick. They work on different usability products for all age groups. What they have proposed, it's a normal ebook that any kid can use, but they have just implemented one small feature in that, a lady interpreting a story in a sign language. So this common book can be used by a small kid which is deaf and dumb. Same book can be used by a kid which is normal, and with a voice, the same book can be used by a partially blind or blind kid. So we need to think of including the features which can be generic, which can be used by any audience, and which can involve more people for the use. What are the key takeaways? Play is the highest form of research, that is Albert Einstein. I just want to check how many of you are here are parents, and how many of you are still a kid by heart? Good. We have discussed a lot of consideration. We have to consider what process, what are the key characters of a kid. But I believe there should be some intangible things we need to consider to succeed in designing user experience for children. So the key takeaway is we need to think like a kid. When we are designing experiences for children, it's itself a very fun-loving domain. So if you are not enjoying this process, or if you are not, you are not loving this process, you will not give a better product, a viable product, which is very good for kids. So on a concluding note, I will just quote one very interesting statement by a very renowned video game designer. She said that only few kids like to be grown up, and only few grown-ups like to be kid. So why don't we design a product which will work for both? So be a kid and enjoy designing experiences for children. That's it from my deck. And have a great evening.